If I were to tell you that Ryan Sieg would be involved in a photo finish over these next couple races where he might almost get his first win, you'd say, okay, next two races, Texas, Talladega, gotta be Talladega, right? You'd be wrong. Sam Mayer, Ryan Sieg in an all-time classic at Texas Motor Speedway. We're gonna recap it all next on Below the Yellow Line.
This is Mario Andretti, and you are listening to Below the Yellow Line.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Below the Yellow Line. I believe we're on episode 221 now for you audio listeners. We all watched this race. We all know what happened. Of course, I'm going to show a clip on screen for you guys anyway right here. But Sam Mayer gets a huge win, a win that might save his season. His struggles to start the year have been well documented. But the star of the show today was Ryan Sieg. Dude went from 10th to 4th. In like three laps, less than that, a Dale Earnhardt-esque charge, if there ever was one. He's leading with 10 laps to go. Everybody's saying, the Fox broadcast saying, oh, there's no way he can hold on this restart. No, he's lost this race. It's over. Dude pulled away. And I know that was because I think you had Custer and Mayer or whoever those guys were. I think Mayer and Jones, somebody side by side. Mayer gets into second. Ultimately, he hunts him down and wins the race. But Ryan Sieg drove the race of his life today. Ryan Sieg drove the last, 25 laps of his life, probably drove the best 25 laps of his life today. This was a guy, today's race was his 342nd Xfinity Series start. He's made over 100 starts in trucks. He's made 6 cup starts. He has never won in the National Series of NASCAR. After today, of course, we all know he still hasn't won in a National Series of NASCAR. The dude's, he's got to be approaching 40, right? I don't know how old exactly he is, but he's just a hardworking guy, family owned team, a guy that has made the playoffs a few times without factory support, without being, a number one Ford program or whatever, like the Penske's and whatnot. And dude just works hard. No excuses. I mean, he didn't give any excuses. He didn't shy away from the fact either that he was trying to put Sam Mayer in the wall on the front stretch. I don't think Sam Mayer would shy away from the fact that he was trying to rough up Sieg. They're just two guys. Sieg, obviously, he's probably thinking about the playoffs maybe a little bit, but playoffs are not. Ryan Sieg was going for his first career win today. That's what matters. Sam Mayer is a guy that coming into this year was expected to be in the championship four. Made it last year. He's expected to be a championship contender. The year has gotten off to a horrendous start, mostly not because of his own actions, because of the team's own actions. They've just been caught up. They've had some good speed, but Daytona, they were involved in a wreck on like the 10th lap of the season, right? And that's kind of set the tone for how their year's gone. This win does magically fix things in the sense that it puts them in the playoffs. They don't have to worry about that. It doesn't magically fix things in the realm of, they do need to get better results consistently. But a top five, I think a second or third last weekend at Martinsville looked like could be another runner-up day today, another great points day. He might even be right inside that playoff bubble. But this win for Mayer is huge. I think his team needed that more than anything, just to prove, hey, we're still in this. We're still a top-tier team. This is Junior Motorsports' first one of the year too. Let's not shy away from that. Second year in a row, JRM's gotten off to a slow start. Allgaier, yes, should have won Phoenix. He was the dominant car today. I think he led over 100 laps in this race. Won stage one, won stage two, finishes third, ultimately restarted fifth. First guy on new tires, just didn't have enough time to get to Mayer, to get to Sieg. 5-10 more laps, maybe he's in the mix for this win. Maybe he steals it from both of them, or maybe it ends differently. I don't know. Big win for Mayer, big win for JRM, but Ryan Sieg is the biggest story of this race. He's going to be who everybody is talking about. And probably regardless of the cup race tomorrow, he's still going to be the talk of the NASCAR town because he's a guy that works hard. He deserves a win more than anybody else. And they showed today, like, hey, we're a force to be reckoned with. They've kind of fallen off these last couple of years. They went from being a playoff bubble team to last year being a 15th place team. You're like, okay. Is this father time catching up to Sieg as a driver? Is it the team regressing a bit? They win with Eric Almirola at Sonoma. And then this year, they nearly pull off a win with Ryan Sieg and Kyle Sieg, even who he is definitely not near as good of a driver as Ryan Sieg, still finishes 14th today. A lot of good underdog-ish runs today. A lot of good runs for guys that really needed it, including Sieg, who, coming into today, I believe he was on the outside looking in for the playoffs right around that bubble, just where he is, where he lives all the time. And, he comes up 2/1000ths of a second short and a finish that's going to be on the highlight reels for years to come. And, you know, I know the Cup race is the race everybody's going to focus on, and rightfully so, but I think these last couple nights have slightly shifted my opinion of Texas Motor Speedway. Last night, great finish in the truck race between Kyle Busch, Corey Heim, Nick Sanchez, Christian Eckes. Today, an all-time classic between Mayer and Ryan Sieg. Texas is still not a good racetrack. It's still got to put on good racing in the Cup Series for me to consider it a good racetrack. But it's been better these last couple nights. So before we get into these results, hats off. You know, I'll take my hat off for a second. Hats off, Ryan Sieg. Hats off, Sam Mayer. Two race car drivers. And again, they didn't shy away from the fact that they're running into each other, trying to wreck each other. They're just going for the win as hard as they can. And I respect that. So Mayer gets the win. Ryan Sieg in second. Justin Allgaier in third. Like I mentioned, he won stage two and stage one. The dominant car on the day, led the most laps. And, not a Phoenix heartbreak situation, but still, they got to get in the victory lane eventually. Amayne Darlington, that's a track he's good at. That's a track where experience trumps everything. And I think Darlington could be a good shot. Dover, too, he's won there before. Who knows about Dega? He's never really been a great, you know, drafting track driver, but who knows? A.J. Allmendinger in fourth. He'll be eyeing Dega as a big shot to win. He has not had a great season. He has not won yet. He's not had the type of year that a lot of people expected him to have. Top five today, this is what we expected from A.J. Allmendinger. Cole Custer in the Andes Frozen Custard car in the Andes Frozen Custard 300 sponsored race. You have Austin Hill in sixth, return to normalcy for him. He had his first finish outside the top 10 last week. Chandler Smith, his regular season championship rival, had his this week in 15th. You had Ryan Truex in his season debut, good run in 7th. Sammy Smith in 8th. Jesse Love won the pole and finished 9th. Fast Pasta Anthony Alfredo in 10th continues his good start to the year. And then you have Taylor Gray in 11th. He made his Xfinity debut at Richmond, finished 3rd. Good run today at Texas after a top 10 in last night's truck race. Josh Williams in 12th. Another solid day for him when they need it. Brandon Jones in 13th. Kyle C. in 14th. And the aforementioned Chandler Smith in 15th. You had Jeremy Clements in 16th. Corey Heim at 17th. Shane Van Gisbergen in 18th. He was off. He qualified 33rd and I believe was 34th in practice. Not a good weekend for them. Showed, you know, that he can drive on the short tracks, and now it's a matter of getting to the intermediates. Only true intermediate they'd really gone to before this, I guess, was Las Vegas probably, and then they head here. So you got a stretch of those coming up. Darlington, Charlotte, Talladega, Dover, will be interesting to see how he does next week at Talladega. Dover, too, the Monster Mile, will be interesting to see how well SVG does there. Sheldon Creed in 19th, had a blazing fast start, I believe three top fives to start the year, and since then he's kind of fallen off a cliff. Matt DiBenedetto, solid top 20 day. Brennan Poole doing what he's done all year, solid day in 21st. Parker Retzlaff, 22nd. Haley Deegan, 23rd. Texas just seems to be a good track for her. It doesn't show in the finish, but she ran around 12th, 13th all day. Finished 6th here in the truck race last year. The broadcast mentioned that Texas, a good track for her. And not many tracks are good for Haley Deegan. So Daniel Dye had a great run in the truck race last night. Same can't be said for his day today in 24th. Parker Kligerman was running just outside the top 10, had a loose wheel, ends at 25th. You have Ryan Ellis, 26th. Riley Herbst ran in the top 5, top 10 all day long. Similar to last season now, Riley Herbst is letting the bad luck get a hold of him. And he had some tire issues late and had to pit. David Starr, 28th. Josh Balicki, 29th. Joey Gase in 30th. Leland Honeyman, 31st. You have Jeb Burton, 32nd. And Patrick Emmerling in 33rd. And let's see who else here. Let me make sure. I know I missed a few results there on the ticker, and I apologize for that. Couldn't quite get all of them on here. So, yeah, you had Patrick Emmerling in 33rd place. Moving on down the list, Garrett Smithley in 34th, Blaine Perkins 35th, Kyle Weatherman 36th, Dawson Cram 37th, and Chad Fincham ends up last 38th, 73 laps down. We don't have the standings yet. We'll have those later when we preview the race at Talladega, but 0.02 of a second, the difference between Ryan Sieg and Sam Mayer. Sam Mayer gets the win, oh so close for Ryan Sieg. Thank you guys for watching. Emily and I will have you covered for tomorrow's Cup race at Texas Motor Speedway. We'll have a post-race show here late tomorrow night. You'd find us on YouTube at Below the Align, on all major podcast platforms at Below the Align, and you can support us financially, Patreon.com /BelowTheYellowLinePodcast. My name is Samuel Stubbs, host of Below the Yellow Line. Thank you for watching, everybody. We'll see you here back tomorrow night to recap the cup race. Sam Mayer, your winner in Texas. Goodbye, everybody. Have a great rest of your Saturday and a great weekend.